This conference will now be recorded.
This video I am showing how to access Linux command line. So the objectives are how to log into Linux and run basic commands. So I am having a Linux virtual machine. So I am going to log in to this Linux. So I am giving username and password I am giving. So we can see that we can see a dollar prompt. So it is indicating that the user is a regular user. If we want to log in as root user, we have to give su hyphen. So the administrator user in Linux is called root. So I am going to log in as root user. So I'm giving su hyphen. So when I do who am I can see the current login, current user I can see from here. So if I want to log out, I can give exit or control D, I can give for logout. So next I want to log into a Linux server. So in our organization we have Linux system, so we want to log into the Linux system. We can give putty and we can give the IP address of the server. So I'm going to connect to the Linux system using putty software. Putty is a SSH client. So we are going to copy this. I'm going to copy the IP address of the system. I'm going to log in. So I can log in as a user now.
This conference will now be recorded.
We can log into a Linux local server by using putty command. So putty is a SSH client. So I am going to copy the IP address and I'm going to log in. So I am increasing the font size. So I am going to log in as a regular user and I am giving the password. And after that I can log in with the root user by using su hyphen. I am switching user as a root. I am going to give the password of the root user. We can see the hash prompt is showing. It is indicating that it is a administrator user. So we can log out by using exit. Sometimes password authentication may be not enabled in the server. So we have to log in using the key based authentication. So I have to give a putty command and I have to give the IP address. So I can log into the server with the IP address and we can go to connection, SSH and auth, and we can provide the key from here. So we can see this key is given. I have a key here. It's a private key I am having here. I am selecting it and I can log into the system. So then password, it will not be asking for the password. So I am just changing the font size. So I am going to log in as a user. So currently I have configured a key based authentication for this user. So we can see that I am able to log in as this user and we can log in to root user also. We can log in. So we can log in like this. So we can also log in by using another client software we can use. So we can use a Git bash client we can use. So previously I connected through putty software. Now I can install this client software Git bash. So it is having a SSH client, so I can I am going to my keys are in my download folder. So I am right clicking. I already installed Git. So I'm going to open Git Bash. So we can open the Git Bash from here. So I can open this from the start menu. So we can directly Git Bash is here. We can select it. Git Bash you can select. So from here we can directly log into this server by using the IP address. So we just need the IP address to log into the server. So I'm going to copy the IP address, and from the Git bash command, so I can log in. So I'm giving a SSH. And I am giving the username Tom at the rate IP address. The username at the rate IP address I have to give. So it will be asking for the password. So it will prompt you yes or no. So we have to give the password. Then we can see we can log in from here. And I can also log in to root user by using su hyphen. And I can log in like this. So now if I am do exit means I can see now I am inside the Linux now. So I can give exit now, and we come out from the we can log out from the Linux. So sometimes we want to log in using so I'm giving a clear command. So I want to log in using a key also. I can log in. So my keys are in my desktop directory, so in my download folder. So I'm going to this folder. So I am going to do SSH, and I can specify the key. I can specify from here. So my key name I have to specify, and I have to log in with the IP address. So the my username I have to specify. So currently I have a user like this, and I have to log in with my IP address. So we can able to see login by using the key. So we can see that now I am inside the Linux system, so I can start giving commands and all I can give. So we are going to discuss all these commands. So I'm going to we can log in from here. So we just see log into the system, and we are going to see the commands. So basic commands how we are going to work. So we can see that I can just go to my parent directory by going to cd slash, and when I do ls, we can see all the folders I can see from here. So ls command, ls is a basic command. It will show all the directories and files. So when I am giving ls hyphen l, this is a option we are giving. So ls hyphen l, l means a option. So because it will show the long listing. So when we are giving ls hyphen l or any this one, we can call it as a option. So and cat command we can see some files content of the file. And suppose in the etc directory I want to open a file, I can give this cat command. I am giving cat is a command for it is similar to it is just typing the content of a file, cat command, and this is the file name. So when I am typing this, it will see the content of the file. So clear, I am clearing. So when we are giving this, we are now this is the argument, this is the command, and this is the argument we are giving. So command having this is the command argument, and we have options also we are having. So every command having options will be there, argument will be there. So we saw how to log into Linux and how to log in through network using PuTTY. Git bash also we have logged in. So now we want to run two commands. You can just I'm going to Linux system. So I want to go to this TMB folder. So this is a folder in my system is called a TMB, and I want to see the ls command. So nothing is there. Otherwise I will go to cd boot directory. There is a folder called the boot, and I can go see the content. So there's two commands I am giving. So cd boot and ls. So these two commands or ls hyphen l also I can give. It will see the long listing. So all the details it will be showing. So I want to give two commands at a time. So I can give this cd slash tmb, and if I give semicolon and a second command I can give. So if I want to do two commands at a time, I can give separate this two command by a semicolon. First the cdtmb will work, so then ls-l will work. We can see when I execute this, both the commands are going to work. So I will go to another directory, cd boot, giving ls-l. So it will go to boot directory. Boot is a folder, and we can run the second command also. It is running. So two commands we want to run at the same time, we can give that command. So we can see some basic commands we can see. So ls command we have seen. So ls command having a lot of options. So we are seeing some basic commands. So I want to change the user password. I can give a password command. We can change the password of the system. So it will ask for the current password. So after that, it will be asking for the new password. So I will log in as a root user now, and I want to change my password. I want to change, so I can give a password command. So it will ask for the current password. So we want to change the new password. I am going to change like this. So I changed the password, and like this, when we do ls means it will show all these files, because currently there is no files in this folder. So we can see the pwd. We are working inside a folder now. So ls-a means it will show the hidden files. So if I do cd slash, it will go to my parent directory. So we can see all my folders are there. So ls-l means long listing. It will show, it will see all the folder size, permissions created, date, and everything it will be showing. So now I can give other commands. So now if I want to see the date command, it will show the date, today's date it will show. So date and time it will show. Like that, if I want to give date hyphen percentage r means it will show only the date. Date percentage.
This conference will now be recorded.
So when I do this date plus percentage r, it will show the time. Just it will show the time. If I do date plus capital, date plus percentage capital R, it will show only that time. And if I just do the date command, it will show the complete date and time. So we can see the help about date command by using man command and date. It will show the complete options for the date command. So we can come out from the man by using just pressing Q. So if we want to see the old commands, so we can just type history. So when I do history means it will show all the old commands. So I want to run a command like sixth command I want to run. So I can give you this exclamation mark and six. So this if I do means it will do the sixth command, it will do again. So this way we can see the history commands. We can see. So today's session is basically, this session is about basics about login to Linux. So we can login using PuTTY. We can login using SSH command. If it's VMware, we can directly login. So thanks for watching.